When you're in some water, you're happy as a clam or a mollusk. It's Phyla and Pam.
Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Phyla and Pam. In today's episode on the featuring the Phyla Mollusca, we're going to be learning the secrets of the mollusk. Now to Clam and Mussel for more information.
Hi kids, I'm Clam.
And I'm Mussel, and as you may know, we're mollusks.
Did you know that the word mollusca really means soft-bodied? Well, that doesn't describe a clam like me with a hard shell, does it? Well, actually it does, because I live inside my shell and use it for protection.
It also is a fitting name to describe the three main groups of mollusks: bivalves, cephalopods, and gastropods. Now to Snail and Slug for more information.
Hey, I'm Snail.
And I'm Slug. We're going to be teaching you kids about gastropods. As my friend Clam just told you guys, that they are one of the three main groups of mollusks.
Gastropods are organisms like abalones, conches, slugs, and snails like us. We have only one shell.
All gastropods have a saw-like tongue called a radula that helps them cut through leaves and scrape algae off rocks. Some cephalopods also have a radula, but are very rare. Now to Mussel for bivalves.
Hey guys, as you already know, I'm a mussel, and I'm a bivalve, which means I have two shells instead of one. My friend Clam is also a bivalve. We are filter feeders, but we don't have a head or a brain, but we do have small rows of eyes and an open circulatory system.
Hey Mussel, are you telling them about bivalves?
I am. Do you want to help me?
Sure. Bivalves and gastropods have something called an open circulatory system, which means instead of having blood transported through vessels, our organs are directly bathed in blood so that the nutrients can get directly to the cells.
That's really cool.
I know.
Now to Octopus for more information about that.
Oh. Hi, my name is Octopus. And I am a cephalopod. Cephalopods are this really awesome type of mollusks that includes nautiluses, octopuses like myself, and squids. Now, one of the great things about us cephalopods is that we have a giant mass of nerve cells in our large heads called a ganglion, and this functions as a brain. We also have a closed circulatory system, which means we have blood running through vessels in our body, like humans do, and unlike other mollusks. I guess we're just really cool like that. Bye, guys.
As a type of group of mollusks, what characteristics do you guys share?
Well, we have muscular foot, which is used for locomotion, in other words, to move.
We all have gills and a heart, which all mollusks use to breathe.
But most importantly,
we have a visceral mask that contains...
As I was saying, it contains the most important organs.
Like digestive organs and circulatory organs and...
respiratory organs and excretory organs!
And reproductive organs!
Enough!
One mollusk answered.
Well, we already told you what a visceral mass is. It contains all of our important organs, but there's a layer of epidermis covering it, and it's called a mantle.
Now, on cephalopod mantles, we have this really awesome thing called a siphon, which we use to use jet propulsion to push us through the water. Let me demonstrate.
Well, folks, that's all we have today on the mystery of the mollusk, Phyla Mollusca. See you next time for another episode of Pam and Phyla on the Phylum Platymentals.
Bye! When you're in some water, you're happy as a clam or a mollusk. It's Phyla and Pam.